Good morning. Hey, let me turn it around. Okay, so I'm reading this book, Take Back Your Life. It's backwards, I know, but you can see it. Take Back Your Life, Recovering from Cults and Abusive Relationships. It's by a woman named Janja Lalic, who, by some fluke of my college alumni network, whose niece went to my college. So I got in touch with her and I went to one of her workshops and she comments on my Facebook posts. It's a really, really clearly written book. I have a few other books, but they're very kind of psychology academic and they make your head brain kind of explode. But this one kind of like talks to people who are in my position and our position and describes what you're going through. It really helps to have kind of a roadmap. And it's hard to explain it all. One of the things I started doing on Facebook is just writing about, started to write stories, and it's scary. Like I can hear people arguing with me, particular people imagined in my head when I write these things. Well, that was just your experience or different things. The system will use all of its strength to try to make it about me, make it my fault or something that was wrong with me particularly, or also just, hey, we told you, or you did it of all of your own free will. So there's something in here which is really brilliant, and it's called Contract for Membership in a Cultic Group or Relationship. So it tells you all the things that will happen so that you can sign up before. Because what happens is, like, you get into it, it feels good. And then 23 years later, you're like, oh my God, I am a squashed bug. How did that happen? So it has all these statements that you sign before you join, these things that will likely happen to you. And one of them that I'm just reading right now is everything that is wrong is due to me. So any conflict that I feel, any problem that I have would be my personal fault for not trying hard enough, not surrendering, not trusting. And it's all imbued with this faith kinds of language. It's a setup because the leader is built up to be this perfect person, and it's implied in many situations that he has magical qualities like controlling the weather, controlling sounds. It's explicit that his actions and his thoughts are in line with God's will. The only way to be in relationship with that standard is to be the person who's always wrong. And it's also explicit in the lore of the community that just accept it, you're wrong. And that actually liberates you. So that's the standard. I'm wrong. And so I learned to be wrong. So, and then one other giant thing that causes the enormous stress in the environment is that we are in 1,000 different ways told to not individuate. So don't take some kind of creative stand or don't go out of the box. Oh my God, that's taught in so many ways, like how you write, how you express, how you think, how you create, how you speak. At one point, we had a exercise where you had to carry 50 pennies around in your pocket, and every time you used the word I or spoke about yourself or changed the topic to be about yourself, you moved a penny. So you were explicitly practiced and rehearsed to not speak about your own experience. However, in situations, so that was the force against you doing that. But if you didn't, in certain situations, quote, use your intelligence and come forward and speak and engage, you were also in trouble for that. So I would go through the day and every moment being afraid to not conform, but also being afraid to not innovate or react in the moment. That is stressful. So today I have things to do, and I have family members who are interested in what's going on, which I really appreciate. So shout out to my lovely nieces and my siblings again for welcoming me back into the fold. I love you, bye.